Belinda Audio presents this unabridged recording of The Muddle-Headed Wombat, written by Ruth Park.
There was once a muddle-headed wombat sitting in the grass and feeling very lonely. Do you know what a wombat is?
It's me!
It's not time for you to come in yet, wombat. Well, a wombat is a square little animal with stumpy legs and no tail to speak of and... Wombat!
Oh, all right.
That's better. Well, there was Wombat sitting in the grass and feeling sad. He hadn't any aunts or uncles, and he'd lost his pocket money.
Oh, if I only had a friend. A nice, comfy little friend who could fit in my cardigan pocket. A wombat could have a great many adventures with a friend like that.
Suddenly he saw, in the paddock nearby, a wooden man waving his wooden arms and squeaking a song of his own. It was a scarecrow. He wore a raggy white coat and a big straw hat and yellow gloves on his wooden hands. Wombat was delighted to see him.
Perhaps I can make friends with him. Too-hoo! Mr. Scarecrow, here comes your little wombat.
Every time the wind puffed over the gullies, the wooden man swung his arms to left and right.
Wah, wah, wah.
But Wombat didn't know this. He thought the scarecrow was waving to him. He stood up on his hind legs and pulled at the scarecrow's coat.
Here I am! Aren't you glad to see me? Ah, wowie wow!
That was the scarecrow's arm thumping poor Wombat on the head. Just as well Wombat's head is as hard as a rock.
Ah, well, you hideous old cobble wobble. That's a nice thing to do to a friend. I'm going to push you over. That's what I'm going to do.
And Wombat put his forehead against the post which held the scarecrow and pushed and pushed until there was a creak and a crack, and down went the wooden man all in a heap. Away bowled his straw hat, with Wombat after it. And somehow it was such a friendly-looking hat, with a nice wavy brim and an airy sort of hole in the crown, that Wombat put it on.
Hello, you dear old hat. You and I can be friends anyway.
Suddenly Wombat heard a queer little noise.
Do you hear that, you dear old hat? That's a very little animal, and it's sad and miserable.
Wombat galumped over to the side of the road and peeped in amongst the tall grass stalks. And there he saw the tiniest, furriest animal rolled into a ball and crying to itself. Wombat had a very soft heart. He just couldn't bear this sad sight. A tear ran down his nose and plopped on the stranger's little head. Straight away, it unrolled itself, sat up and said crossly,
"And now it's raining. This isn't awful."
"Oh, it isn't raining at all, silly. It's me crying."
"Well, don't cry on me, whoever you are. I have enough trouble already."
The little animal closed up its mouth in a tight, worried way and began pawing around in the grass.
"I'm looking for my glasses. I've dropped them.
Oh, look, I'm good at losing things, so I expect I'm good at finding things too."
Wombat scrabbled around in the grass, and in a moment he'd found the lost spectacles. They were just about as tiny as spectacles can be. In fact, the little animal used a pea pod for carrying them in. Wombat was delighted with himself for finding them.
"There you are! Aren't I clever? Aren't I smart?"
The little animal popped the glasses on and looked at Wombat. It started at his toes and worked upwards. And by the time it had reached the top of his hat, it had quite a crick in the neck.
"Oh, you really are dreadfully big."
"Oh, I can fold up a bit. You watch."
He sat down, pulled his toes and humped his neck. He even tried to turn his ears down. Then he beamed.
"See? Now I'm little."
"You know, you don't look very..." very sensible to me.
Oh, I've got lots of brains. You listen while I shake my head. See? My brains just don't fit tightly, that's all. Oh, you are a nice little animal. What's your name?
I'm a mouse.
Like the mouses that live in houses?
Oh, I'm an outdoors mouse. I'm a fat tail pouch mouse.
To prove it had a pouch, the mouse took a peanut out of its pocket, bit it in half with its sharp teeth, and gave half to Wombat. Wombat was very happy.
Please be my friend and have adventures with me and ride in my cardigan pocket. Please do, Mouse.
The mouse liked the look of Wombat. It liked his stumpy paws and his twinkly black eyes. It liked his whiskers and his funny sewn-on nose. It decided it might just as well live in his hat as anywhere else.
After all, the hat's got a lovely window in it.
The mouse scooted up Wombat's arm and under his new straw hat. The next moment, its long pink nose stuck out of the hole in the front.
My! It's nice up here, Wombat. Oh, Wombat, look!
What at?
There's a very interesting sort of thing coming along the road.
Wombat pushed his hat off his eyes and looked. And he saw that the interesting sort of thing was another animal. It was about as big as himself, but not so square. It was a furry grey with a red scarf around its neck and a cowboy hat. One ear stuck out from under the hat, and a very tattered, chewed-looking ear it was too.
It's only a pussy, a dear, sweet old pussy.
Don't like it.
You do so. Everybody likes pussies.
Well, mouses don't.
By this time, the pussy was quite near, and Wombat called out excitedly.
Hello, Cat. Good morning, Cat.
Yeah.
I beg your pardon.
I said, yeah.
Ooh, Wombat.
Poor little mouse dived right to the bottom of Wombat's pocket and sat there shivering.
I don't think you've got any manners, Cat.
Of course I haven't. I'm the toughest, roughest, wildest cat in Australia.
Oh, are you truly, really, truly, really?
I chew up enormous dogs and I bite the legs off grizzly bears. Meow.
Oh, you do not. You've got a nice, kind old face.
Oh, I have not.
Oh, yes, you have. You got soft-hearted paws, too. I think you're sweet. What's your name?
Tabby.
Tabby what?
Tabby Cat, stupid.
Isn't that clever? Tabby Cat. Well, I'm Wombat.
You look as silly as a wet week.
Oh, yes, I am, too.
Wombat thought that Tabby Cat was very smart to notice how muddle-headed he was. But down in his cardigan pocket, Mouse grumbled to itself.
I just don't like cats, and I'm not going to like this cat. My, I'll have to watch out for myself.
But Wombat thought his new friend was very exciting. And the tougher Tabby tried to be, the more Wombat liked him.
I chew up elephants, and I knock down lions with one sweep of my paw.
Oh, I wish I could. And what else do you do, old catsy-watsy?
I catch sharks.
Dead ones?
No, of course not. Real live sharks with hundreds of teeth. I sit on a rock and catch them with my claws.
There, he's making it all up.
Mouse became so interested that it crept up the pocket and stuck its little head over the top. Suddenly, Tabby Cat saw it.
Hey,
What's the matter? Did you stand on a prickle?
I thought I saw a mouse.
You mean this here mouse? This is my mouse.
Hey, I can't bear mice. I think I'm going to faint.
Oh, look, Mouse. He's fallen over and turned up his toes.
My, I frightened a cat. Wombat, this is the proudest day of my life.
Very soon, Tabby Cat opened his yellow eyes and sat up. Mouse said kindly,
You needn't be frightened of me, Tabby. I won't hurt you.
You'd better not. I may be frightened of mice, but I'm not frightened of anything else.
Catsy-watsy, please catch me a shark like you said.
I never catch sharks on Wednesdays.
As a matter of fact, Tabby Cat had a secret.
Don't you tell anyone, but I'm not a fierce, scratchy cat at all. I'm just a great big softy. Oh, it's awful to be a soft-hearted cat.
Yes, Tabby was just make-believe fierce. But he hoped that Mouse and Wombat would never find it out. So he crouched and snarled and lashed his tail from side to side.
Oh, I wish Wombats had tails like Tabby.
Oh, poo.
But before Tabby's tail had lashed more than twice, it had knocked a bee from the nearby branch. The bee was very angry. It got up, brushed the dust off its football jersey and looked around for its enemy. And there it saw a fine, long, grey tail. The bee picked out a nice, soft spot and...
Ooh, ow, ooh. That's a lovely noise. Do it again.
Down from the tree came Tabby. He whirled around like a top, trying to catch his tail. Then he streaked up the tree and down the other side.
Isn't Tabby busy?
Oh, he's just showing off, the silly thing. Pooh.
If I ran up a tree, I'd fall on my big square head. I think Tabby's ever so smart.
Just then, Tabby came streaking back, holding the end of his tail under his arm. Oh, how it hurt.
Oh, I'm burning up. Send for the fire brigade.
Why? Are you on fire?
That's a horrible headachy noise you're making, Tabby. It makes my ears wobbly.
I can't help it. I'm going to die. Oh, goodbye all.
Tabby stretched out as straight as he could on the ground and closed his eyes. Wombat and Mouse thought it was all a joke.
Goody, 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 goody. Now we can play funerals.
You're very mean, Annie Miles. You don't care that a bee bit me.
Now Wombat and Mouse were ashamed of themselves, for they had not known that Tabby was hurt. Mouse, who loved to be a nurse, scuttled out of the pocket and ran over to poor Tabby.
You're not going to chop my tail off.
What a very good idea, eh, Mouse?
Silly, the best way to treat a bee sting is to rub some blue stuff on it.
Oh, I'll die.
You mean blue stuff like a blue ribbon?
You are, muddle-headed wombat. I mean a special blue stuff that ladies use when they're washing clothes. We've just got to find a lady and she'll give us some.
Well, I can't walk. Wombat will have to carry me.
But Wombat had ideas of his own about carrying bee-stung cats. He picked Tabby up by the tail and trotted along, swinging him like a shopping bag. And no matter how much Tabby screeched and yelled, Wombat took no notice. Soon they reached a house where a kind lady said that they could certainly have the loan of her blue bag.
Will it hurt very much?
It might hurt a poor little pouched mouse, but it wouldn't hurt a great big brave tiger cat like you.
Can't I do it, Mouse?
Certainly not. I'm the nurse.
You never let me do anything.
Wombat dabbed with the blue bag, and Mouse snatched it back and dabbed too, and they squabbled and snatched and fought until poor Tabby was blue all over. At last, the lady became tired of their bad behaviour and she took the blue bag from them and fixed up Tabby's sting herself.
Oh, there, you poor old pussy. Now, you come with me and I'll give you a saucer of milk.
Meow.
Tabby followed the lady into the kitchen, but Wombat and Mouse were so busy fighting, they didn't notice him go. One day, Wombat was paddling in a cool creek and wishing that his legs were longer.
Because then I'd have more of me to paddle, of course.
When all at once, he saw a gleam of a bright gold amongst the water grass.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.